wealth is its own reward. My heart I have found gets carved surely by the pound. God knows I tried to hold you with all my might, but time
gentlemen, this is the Hoodoo Gurus live in the studio, and we're going to play you a song we've never played live before, so let's see how we go on this one.
Sweet song.
bad for a first time. What is it you want from me? There isn't much I will not do. If it's only company, you know I might need that too. Oh, you come anytime. Butchered every sacred cow. Don't tell me all the things you might have done. Tell me, what are you doing now, right now? Come anytime.
Come anytime.
I won't give you pressure.
Come anytime.
Come anytime. Hey, I can wait forever. And if you can't make up your mind, we could make it up together.
Yeah.
answered prayer. I feel the yearning need. Now you depend on me, so you can go to hell. I don't want you. 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 I don't want you.
Triple M's Garage Session with the Hoodoo Gurus live. Dave Faulkner and the boys, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here now in the middle of a pandemic.
I've seen the Gurus play many stages across Australia, from Shell Harbour Workers Club in southern coast of New South Wales for the first time in 94, through to the Playpen in Cairns on the last tour before the band broke up, to the Tivoli in Brisbane. I've even seen you at a State of Origin game in Brisbane where I kept fangirling and looking over my shoulder going, it's him. It's really
him. I know.
But I've never seen you.
We were fangirling about, you know, seeing Wally Lewis and people like that.
I've never seen you like this down a computer screen. This is fun.
I know, mate. It's a very weird world, but I've been in it for a while now. I guess everyone else has been too.
Hey, let's talk about gigs. From playing Rio to 40,000 to touring with Metallica on the big day out, what are some of the great gigs that come to mind when you talk about the great shows the Gurus have been part of?
One really great one for me was when we did a show called Homebake, which I don't think it goes anymore, but was at in Sydney. We'd broken up at the time because we broke up for 6 years at one point, and we were really serious about that. And Homebake was so fantastic, we kind of, you know, gave us the itch to come back together again 2 years later. So, and that's why we're still here since then. But other ones, maybe playing on board a Navy ship in Western Australia, but that was about to go to have its final voyage before it was decommissioned. That was pretty incredible. Geez, a million of them really, but those are pretty close to kind of the weirdest ones.
The Hoodoo Gurus music just seeps into Australia's way of life. When you mentioned the playing on the Navy ship, was that the one that would play your song 1,000 miles away every time they'd leave port?
That's the one, yeah. Basically, my father had served on the previous version of the Canberra, and this was the Canberra 2.
Wow.
Canberra 1 sunk in World War 2, and my father survived, luckily. That's why I'm here. But someone on the ship must have heard about my connection to the ship, you know, through my father, and they used our song. And many years later, they've been playing it, you know, every time they left port or, you know, arrived in port. So all their families associated that song with the ship so much that they wanted us to be part of the decommissioning as well.
Wow, what a heartfelt connection.
It was amazing. And my dad was still alive then, so that was even better for me personally. It was an incredible moment for father-son thing.
Far out, getting shivers hearing about that. That is awesome. And there's other less shivery things that you're connected with in Australia's way of life. Well, the TV show where Come Anytime was used every time Thank God You're Here would start.
That's right, yes. They got it for a bargain, by the way, let me tell you. they caught us unawares. You know, we didn't realise that show would be a huge hit. And it went for years and they just kept that same crappy contract the whole time.
Mate, you and Harrison Ford in Star Wars ripped off. Should have had shares.
The thing is, though, I mean, I'm glad that gave that song more profile and people started to, you know, that became one of the biggest songs in a way, you know, after having that exposure. So, it was a good thing.
And then just before you guys get back together, What's My Scene turns into That's My Team, and that's just been around forever.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, well, I mean, that song was pretty big already, so it just gave it a kind of a new, new wrinkle.
Yeah.
I was just going to show you where everyone else is too. Here's Rick over here. You can see Mr. Grossman.
Hey, Rick.
He's saying hey.
It's been a while. Folks, I saw you on stage with the Divinals about 20 years ago, and that was it. So nice to see you.
He saw you on stage with the Divinals, you're saying, about 20 years. A bit more than 20, I'd say.
a little bit more.
And, of course, here's Nick, our fabulous drummer. Nick, can we see you?
Hey, Nick. Thanks for banging the drums for us, buddy.
Howdy.
Yeah. Nick has been giving us a new lease on life and added some sparkle to our sound. And, of course, speaking of sparkle, Mrs. Sparkle here. Brad Shepherd.
Still the best looking rooster in the band. Hey, and if you could just...
His wife's just in the other room, so you be careful.
Nice to meet the band. The Gurus and Triple M are of similar vintage. We turn 40 this year. You've got your 40th next year.
Actually, on New Year's Eve is actually the 40th anniversary of when the band formed. It's incredible.
Wow.
It took us 9 months to actually get and play out a show, but that's the day we decided to do it, was New Year's Eve 1980, just in the early hours of 1981. So yeah, this New Year's Eve, we're going to probably do something online just to kind of like say, you know, pay tribute to that kind of moment in time.
And right now you were supposed to be touring in America. So obviously that'll be part of the 40th celebrations, getting back over there.
Yeah, we are planning to go back there in September, October next year. So we'll see how that goes. They're still kind of climbing the hill of COVID-19 right now. Hopefully they'll get we'll get a vaccine or something. It'll change everything. But right now it's not looking good for anyone.
You got a couple of Americans.
We're doing okay.
Yeah, that's the main thing, that you're fine and healthy and rocking for us.
We're all good. You saw our video, like, for the new single. You know, it's very COVID unsafe. Actually, we were being safe, but it's a lot of people in one spot. Couldn't do that anywhere else in the world right now.
Yeah, that's a great supernatural theme to that. Love it. It'd be a lot of fun.
yeah, absolutely. We like dressing up, you know. Famously, starting with What's My Scene, we've always been a bit of a mugglers in front of the camera.
If you haven't seen that, by the way, Triple M's, check it out on the Facebook page for the Gurus. It's really good.
Yeah, and get out of Dodge, baby.
Yeah, you got a couple of Americans joining you on that one. A relationship that goes way back to the 80s with Vicky Peterson from the Bangles. And you've got a Beach Boy on there. How did that happen?
Yeah, John Castle. Oh, well, he's a friend of Vicky's. In fact, a very close friend of Vicky's. We are huge fans of the Castles and that whole sort of Californian sunshine pop thing. So as soon as we knew that Vicky had some connection with John, we were like, come on, both of you guys. I mean, they'd been recording together on other things, so it just seemed like a natural thing for us. And it actually came out of the way the song sounded to me. It kind of reminded me of that sound in the chorus, and the harmonies were something I thought they'd eat up, and they did. They just made them sound amazing. We don't do those harmonies live, by the way. You would have just heard that. We leave those bits out for Vicky and John. So you have to just imagine they're there.
Yeah, sure.
And we sing the other harmonies, but not the bits that they sang.
Yeah, as good looking as your guitarist is, he's no Vicky Peterson.
No, none of us are. She's still fantastic.
What I like about the new song is it sounds great in a mix of classics as well, and you get it straight away and you go, wow, this is great. It's bouncy and you want to move to it. It's a lot of fun. It's very summery. How do legendary songs in your catalogue that we all know and love affect how you write new music?
Yeah, it doesn't affect it. It's just I'm the same person. You know, I love melody and I love, and the lyrics have got to mean something to me. So when that comes together the right way, you know, you get some magic and then you get the band playing it as well, and that completes the whole picture. So it's just, you never know when you start out, but, we got in the rehearsal room and straight away that song, I think it was Brad actually said it first. He said, that sounds like the single.
Yeah,
and
nice.
He just liked the title pretty much straight away. He thought that's such a great name for a song. He didn't even know what I was talking about yet, but he just liked the catchy tune and the title and it just grew. It grew from there. So yeah, we're pretty proud of that one. And for us, we've never really been quite that sunshine pop before. We've had very poppy melodies before, but not quite as obviously paying tribute to the Beach Boys and that sort of whole era. We just love that stuff.
Yeah, well, we loved premiering it too for the first day of Oztober on Triple M. Thank you for that gift.
Thank you for that gift. Oztober, we are very proud to be a part of, and Triple M has been wonderful for us. So, we're very glad to be involved any way we can.
Yep, we've enjoyed paying off your mortgage for 40 years, and that is not going to end anytime soon, my friend.
My friends keep complaining. They keep saying, you're on there all the bloody time, Don't stop, guys. Keep annoying my friends.
Yeah, keep being involved. Thank you so much for being part of Triple M's Oztober, the Garage Sessions, and launching it for us. This is the first of four. We're going to have a lot of fun with these. Thank you for breaking mid-set for us. Why don't you head back and jam out another couple of tunes, one of which did feature Vicky Peterson on vocals when it came out the first time.
You got it. I'll get my guitar and I'll be right with you.
Nice. Dave Faulkner, the Hoodoo Gurus, thank you.
Estimated time of arrival, 9:30 a.m. Been up before the sun and now I'm tired before I even begin. Now you're flying, I got so much work in front of me. Really flying, it stretches out far as the eye can see. I can see. Spend half my life in airports, doing crosswords or attempting to sleep. Rather be 1,000 miles away.
Ladies and gentlemen, a pleasure. The Hoodoo Guru say, see ya.